It might be known as America's pastime, but President Obama will find Cubans just as passionate about baseball. While in Havana, he would do well to come down to 12th Street to watch the island's young talent play a few innings. These children know there's an important visitor in town, but have little idea of just how historic his trip is. Not since 1928, when Calvin Coolidge visited the island, has a sitting US president come to Cuba. In those days, relations were close. Too close, some felt. After Fidel Castro and his revolutionaries took power, there followed 5 decades of Cold War hostility, including the failed invasion at the Bay of Pigs. But President Obama and Raul Castro have reset the relationship, re-establishing diplomatic ties and lifting travel and trade restrictions. They even reinstated direct mail. Ileana Yarza was among the first to receive that mail from the United States. She wrote to ask the president to lift the economic embargo. Her reply came from Barack Obama himself.
He said he would be coming to Cuba. He would be strengthening values and links, which is exactly what I think should happen.
The White House says President Obama will hold talks with dissidents and won't avoid the question of human rights while in Cuba. The Cubans say he can raise whatever issue he likes.
Cuba, of course, is open to discuss and to exchange views with the United States about every issue, including human rights, democracy, whatever. But Cuba has been very clear saying that those issues are not for negotiation. So matters that are for internal decision and sovereignty of the Cuban government, the Cuban people, will not be negotiated with the United States.
This trip will be a big test for President Obama's new friendship with Cuba. There are some tough questions on the table, but there will be much warmth too, as most Cubans simply want to thank him for having turned the page on the past. Will